Ayaz, welcome.
Thank you so much, JJ.
Let's start with this whole issue of the registration, or rather the intake, particularly of grade 1s and grade A. How many people have now been placed and how many are not?
Thanks for the opportunity, JJ. You know, our online registration was a transformation agenda that we're trying to advance to ensure that all our schools are open to all our parents. So we needed a system that does not have the human element, where people can just apply and they don't have to queue.
The AfriForum case, can you just educate me a little bit about what it to them now?
Well, there's no case. The case is that those people that are queuing, waiting for spaces, is no longer one race. Yeah, it's everyone.
Yeah. There's this now standard 9 exit, which we're told, no, it's not really exit. It's just to give people, you know, another stream and so on. But because it has been introduced out of the blue, it confused society. Please explain to me.
Let me explain it. The introduction of grade 9 as an area in which it gives learners that don't want to follow the academic stream, but want to follow the technical stream or the vocational stream, it gives them that option to say, you can now go to what previously used to say are technicons. So we're creating that pathway. Because the benefits are huge there.
Also busy with turning the classrooms into real electronic sense or format of teaching. How's that going?
In Gauteng, JJ, if you need a chalkboard and you need a chalk and you need a duster, you must go to a museum. You'll never come to our schools. It's one classroom, one smart board, one teacher, one laptop, one learner, one tablet, one school, one free Wi-Fi, so that our children can be part of this revolution that is taking place.
What is happening there in terms of special schools?
Well, we're making meaningful progress there. When we came, we had learners that were on the waiting list to be part of the special schools. That waiting list was sometimes 3 to 4 years just to wait to get a school. We've reduced that to 18 months. It's still a lot. We are working around the clock to ensure that every learner that wants to go to a special school, they must get access immediately.
Safety at schools, kids stabbing each other, dying on our school grounds. What's your perspective there?
We need to find a mechanism of ensuring that our law enforcement agencies do their work, and that we need to ensure that parents don't donate their parental responsibilities to the educators. School violence is not an education problem. It's a societal problem. And the sooner we assist each other, the better.